Welcome to Moving Forward with Uponor. I'm Daniel.
And I'm Marcus.
And we're going to be here every Thursday to talk to you about all things Uponor, including plumbing, hydronics, and industry. If you guys have any questions for us, you can comment down below and we'll see if we can maybe work that into a section or something and we can try and answer those. And also make sure if you guys like this video to like and subscribe down below. So let's jump right into it, Marcus. What is our topic going to be for today?
Well, for this first session, I'd like to talk about the history of Uponor. Where did Uponor come from? I think there's a lot of value to share with the industry and our customers, and really how we progressed and how we're now an industry partner with a lot of contractors, a lot of customers. And you know, through that partnership, where you can really solve the issues, concerns, industry problems that are on the job site, that are in the pre-construction stage, that are in the design, the modeling, all the way down from to the components for the pipe and fittings. So I think we can start there and have a great discussion.
All right. So I think the first thing we'll do is we're going to hop in our time machine, right? And we're going to jump back to 1984, all right? Wirsbo takes the world by storm, North America probably in particular, takes North America by storm, introducing PEX-a for radiant heating in North America. Obviously, you know, big deal. First time people had seen radiant in general in North America, let alone a plastic piping that's getting put in your floor system, right? Move into the 90s, Wirsbo sets up shop in Apple Valley, Minnesota, right? So we've been in this same building since 1990. And kind of ever since then, ever since we've kind of staked our claim here in Minnesota, it's kind of just been, like you said, right, solving customer problems and kind of evolving with the industry and kind of customer needs, right?
Yeah, that's right, Dan. So kind of, you know, when you can think about the history, the 40 years, the rich history that Uponor has, it's really, you know, back to those different buckets in the industry where we started residential radiant. You know, we were the dominant player, the market leader in residential radiant heating. You know, and from there, it was trades on the job site say, hey, what are you putting in the floor there for radiant heating? You know, what do you think we can do that for plumbing? Well, sure, you know, we sure did. So from there, going from a Wirsbo radiant heating, we moved into the residential plumbing. And so now, even today, through the, as you can see, through the 2000s, Uponor moved into the residential plumbing applications, have dominated there. We've come out with different solutions, multi-port tees, and continue to innovate there. We partnered with Milwaukee Tool to come out with a new M12 tool for installation. You know, so really, you know, that's the first two buckets, and moving there, the last one that's exciting that we're really going to dive into the series is where Uponor is at and talking about beyond in the commercial industry. And that's through going up to PEX products, AquaPEX for 2-inch, 2.5-inch, 3-inch, so that large diameter applications. We went from owning and dominating the in unit, the small diameter, but now, as you can see in the timeline, from basically the early 2000s, almost a decade now, we've been in commercial applications through large diameter piping, through additional tool innovations with Milwaukee Tool, and continue to innovate there.
Right, and like Marcus said, right, as we moved into residential for plumbing, right, everybody's seen what's happened in single family market and residential over the last 25, 30 years, right? You barely ever see metallics or copper piping in new homes anymore. And obviously our end goal is to do that exact same thing and disrupt the commercial market. And we feel like we have a good strategy and a good plan to do that. And I think one of the other things that Marcus hit on, right, is that obviously having a tool partner like Milwaukee has helped us tremendously. I mean, guys used to be doing the old hand tool like a bolt cutter for expanding pipe. There's no way you're using a hand expander on 3-inch PEX, right? So I mean, it's been a great partnership with us since the late 2000s. And then obviously you guys can see some green pipe up here too. So we've also introduced a PP-RCT line for hydronic piping. That's really gonna help us kind of grow into bigger pipe sections and more applications in the hydronic market.
Yeah, that's right, Dan. I think that just continues too, going into the commercial market, which is the next section I'd like to talk about, is how Uponor has continued to innovate through that large offering. But you know, taking even a step back is not just through the product and services, but also through the warranty. Uponor has a 25-year warranty for commercial applications. You know, Uponor's product, our tube and fittings is a system. We warrant our system for 25 years, and that's just not a warranty of craftsmanship, you know, on our manufacturing craftsmanship from Uponor, but it's really, you know, we're going to stand behind our product. The warranty is transferable to owners. It's, you know, covering damages, pipe, any extra, you know, labor, you know, to make it right. And that's where I think Uponor is proud of, is that, hey, you know, we are a system. It's, you know, because we are a system, the innovation in engineering, in support, in on-site training, and even classroom training, we have those establishments, we have those roots here in Apple Valley, Minnesota, but also in the industry. And I think that's something that's really powerful, is having that 25-year warranty compared to even metallic fittings in commercial applications, you know, where they may only carry a one-year warranty, or even because it's not a system, you could have the metallic fittings be different from the metallic tube or pipe manufacturers, and then you're really saying, well, who's who, what's what there. But with Uponor's HEPEX or AquaPEX piping system, really delivers a strong 25-year warranty that we stand behind, and you can see the history we came from. Uponor has been around almost 40 years, and it's not going anywhere, and we continue to innovate through products and services.
Right. Yeah, and like Marcus said, right, system warranty is a huge deal for building owners, right? It's one of those things where sometimes it's an afterthought, but having a company like Uponor that can provide the entire system and have it all be under one warranty umbrella is really a great thing in case anything ever were to happen in the future.
Yep, that's exactly. So just the history of that Uponor has with that 25-year warranty, I think it's important. You know, another challenge that Uponor has overcome is the skilled labor challenges that we hear quite often about. You know, and through the innovation of our tube and fittings, you know, our the tools that we have are, you know, they're innovative. So not only are they battery operated, you know, with our partner in Milwaukee Tool, but, you know, just down to the little things like an auto rotation on the head. So when you're expanding the pipe in the ring, the head will rotate automatically. So you don't have the old kind of bolt cutter type and have to worry about rotating the head. You know, we're down to the details of auto rotation. Same thing, you know, with the tools, it does not require a calibration as opposed to some of the press fittings that you may see out there where the expansion tool, whether it's the M12, M18, or Force Logic, does not require any type of calibration. So really that end user ability and handling of the tools provides a better experience, still requires some skill to put it together, but definitely provides a more efficient solution.
Yep, and it's that simplification like Marcus talked about, right? It's now, instead of having to calibrate tools, now it's just general maintenance, right? So it's greasing heads, it's making sure your batteries are good operating condition, all that kind of stuff. And then obviously with the product too, right, we've done a lot of different, products changed right over the years since 1990, so we've done a lot of innovating with the product based off of customer feedback.
Yeah, that's right. And some of that feedback that we've had too was the issue concern with dry fitting. That's where a installer would take the fitting, assemble it to the pipe, but really wouldn't make that permanent connection. So, you know, through that innovating and that customer feedback, you know, we knew that we did not want to have a system where an installer could dry fit. We've heard too much feedback from the industry's concerns. Someone would dry fit a system, come back, maybe miss a connection. A day later, a month later, a year later, that connection would fail. So one thing, you know, just to talk about that is with Uponor AquaPEX or HEPEX system, you cannot dry fit the system. So you can't have that false connection. That fitting needs to be made. It's a permanent connection. So when you do make that connection, however, you can rotate the fitting in the tube. So it provides a great opportunity for the installer to make the connections, make the joints, but if he needs to make that alignment, turn it 90 degrees, turn it 180 degrees, he can turn that fitting within the pipe. It won't degrade the joint. You know, that's just part of that skilled labor challenge that Uponor continues to overcome. You know, and at the same time too, is the ring that we require for each joint. It's got a stop on it, so we manufacture a little stop on that, so there's no question on how far to push that ring down and to make that expansion.
Yep, can only go on one way, right? So it's pretty hard to mess it up. And that's on every single ProPEX ring, all the way from 3/8 inch all the way up to 3 inch. And then last but not least, we can't talk about, you know, macro trends and customer problems without talking about productivity, right? So productivity is a big hot word today in the construction industry. And that's mostly because it hasn't improved, right? We look at manufacturing, different industries, and productivity's gone up. And in construction, unfortunately, it's just not caught up to some of those other industries. So obviously as a manufacturer, one of the things that, one of the best ways we could potentially help our customers is to make them more productive. So things like, for example, pipe weight. So pipe weight is a big thing in terms of, you know, body strain, people being able to move things around a job site, right? So if we talk about copper, for example, this is a piece of 2-inch type L copper, about 27 inches long. This weighs about 5 pounds, okay? This same length of 2-inch Aquapex weighs 1.5 pounds, right? So that's a big difference, especially if you're carrying around 10-foot, 20-foot sticks of that all day long around a job site. Weights from hanging on the building, on the structure, job site elevators, that kind of stuff, big deal.
Yeah, that is a big deal, Dan. I mean, not just talking physical structure challenges or and weights, but also just the ergonomics of an installer doing ladder work, you know, whether it's a team working in two or three or even single, doing any aerial work, whether it's in a scissor lift or boom type lift, just being able to manage the pipe safely is a big concern and is a, you know, an importance on a job site. We want to make sure that everyone stays safe, and Uponor's products is lightweight and manageable, that really provides that ability to be safe, right, whether when you're working at an elevated installation.
Yep. And last but not least, fitting prep, right? So obviously with metallic piping systems with copper, you should be sanding, deburring, reaming pipe, whether it's soldering or pressing, right? And with our PROPEX system, depending upon what you cut with, and we'll talk about that in a different video, there's very minimal prep to do a connection, right? You cut it square, you might remove some debris, put your ring on, and you're good to go. So very minimal prep time. And that's something a lot of guys don't take into consideration. I know all the guys out there doing copper say they ream and sand their joints, but we know that that's not true. So that's right. So we talked about a lot today, obviously, right? We talked about the history of kind of Wirsbo and Uponor. We've talked about kind of our move into commercial, kind of present day. So obviously we're gonna kind of keep talking about these topics and in all different episodes. We've got some really cool stuff on tap for our additional episodes. Make sure you guys like and subscribe down below. And thanks again for checking out Moving Forward with Uponor.
Thank you for watching.